Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1983. Today, we're going to talk about Archon. The story of Archon takes us to an American video game company named Electronic Arts. Electronic Arts was founded in 1982 by Trip Hawkins. Trip Hawkins had worked for Apple since 1978 when the company was still small. Hawkins met with venture capitalist Don Valentine in 1982 to discuss his options. Valentine recommended that Hawkins start his own company, so Hawkins founded Electronic Arts in November 1982. Hawkins built his company by recruiting employees from Apple, Atari, Xerox PARC, and VisiCorp, some of the biggest names of the time. Hawkins even got Steve Wozniak, who we have talked about several times, to sit on the board of directors. Poised for success, Electronic Arts started releasing games in 1983. Archon was one of their first games. Archon was designed by Paul Reich III and John Freeman. Paul Reich III had worked for TSR as a writer. He had written a few advanced Dungeons & Dragons adventures, including The Ghost Tower of Inverness and Isle of Dread. It was at TSR that Paul Reich III met John Freeman. John Freeman had founded his own video game design company in 1978, named Automated Simulations, although it would be better known by its later name, Epix. We briefly talked about the company before, as they had created Temple of Apshai. Freeman left Epix in 1981 to found a new company with Anne Westfall, a programmer, as well as Paul Reich III. This company was named Free Fall Associates. Free Fall Associates would sign two development contracts with Electronic Arts, commonly known as EA. One of them was to create Archon. Reich and Freeman worked on the design of the game, while Westfall worked on the programming. Inspired by sword and sorcery titles, as well as the holographic chess game shown in Star Wars, Archon has a similar look to chess. It was originally designed to be a two-player game, but EA insisted on a one-player mode. Archon is a strategy game. The player controls a set of pieces arranged on a board similar to a chessboard. Unlike chess, though, when two pieces meet in Archon, the two pieces go into a fight. The winner of that fight determines which piece is eliminated and which piece remains. The player's ultimate goal is either to control all five control points or to eliminate all the enemy pieces, except for the last one, which is imprisoned. Each piece has its own fighting style, and the pieces will gain an advantage if the fight takes place on a square of the player's color. Some pieces will move quickly, some will have ranged weapons, and some will have more health than others. Using the pieces' abilities effectively is crucial to the player's victory. Electronic Arts released Archon for the Atari 400 and 800 computers in 1983. That is the short backstory to Archon. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. As you can see, Freefall Associates and Westfall, John Freeman, Paul Reich III, all part of this game. We can all see that Electronic Arts did publish it. This is Archon. And I did want to let the music play a little bit for you there. It is definitely inspired by Star Wars. It does kind of go its own path eventually, though. All right, so we will see these again, but we have knights, goblins, archers, manticores, valkyries, banshees, golems, trolls, unicorns, basilisks, genies, dragons, phoenix, shapeshifters, wizards, and sorceresses. All right, so all of those are available for us. We could let the demo play. There's not a lot going on in it. It just kind of shows you the game. So we're going to change the option here. It starts at two player. We will have the computer be the dark mode. Select will change who goes first. We're going to have the light side go first. That would be me. And we will start. And I'll try to explain things as we go along. It's going to be a long game, so we don't necessarily want the computer to get a head start on us. All right, so these light colored tiles here, the tile color is very important. We want all of our characters kind of on these light tiles. We want to move some of our characters from the light dark tiles to the light tiles. That's kind of going to be our first thing that we're going to do. So we'll start by moving the knight there. Notice that they're kind of doing the same. We want to move our knight there. Sorceress is summoning an elemental. Sending it all the way to, I believe, my genie. What has my genie attack? Not well. you have to hold the button down first and hold the direction down first. Wow. I got smoked there. And then hit the attack button. All these other tiles, they will change colors as you move forward. So I was already at a disadvantage there. We'll see what I can do. We'll have the phoenix fly to the middle there. All right, they're changing colors back to the lighter side. Oh, I can't move there, can I? Shouldn't have done that. All right, wasted a turn there, but that's okay. Kind of. All right, we will move you here. And you are someone I can't really move all that much. Archer can move there. Okay, you got one of the points of power. That's okay. Valkyrie can fly, but we're just going to put it there for now. All right, so this is pretty much as light as things are going to get for me. So I'm going to try to take on you there. All right, Archer versus Archer. There we go. That's the advantage of being on the color tile that you are strong in. And where do I want to go next? I want to move you there. And you can finally move on to a light tile there. We want to move the Valkyrie there. Conjures a spell. Teleport. Who are you teleporting? All right. This is probably not going to work out well for me. All right, Unicorn. You got to get close. Oh, well, so much for that. I got hit pretty early on. Unicorns, they do have lasers coming out of their horns, but it didn't work out well for me there, did it? Looks like I only got a couple enemies or a couple of my pieces left on variable tiles. So I'll just try to move yours to the other side there. Okay. I guess I'll move you there. And I'm going to be screwed over here. So the archer versus the manticore. I believe you can also attack from the distance. Yep, and I got caught there. One more hit and I'm gone, and I cannot land a shot to save my life. And there I go. I'm not particularly good at a lot of these controls on a lot of these characters. It is difficult, and the computer is much better than I am. Let's see. Let's move you here. And will you move you here? Try to take one of the control points as it's going to turn to the light side here. All right, we're going to go for a fight. This is fairly even. Valkyrie versus Valkyrie. Yeah, you only get so many attacks too. Jeez. Getting the floor wiped with me here. That's probably to be expected though. All right, yeah, that shapeshifter, he's pretty strong. All right, I'll have the Valkyrie go here against the Manticore, see if I can't win one of these fights. I hit up, it, you know, like there's so much of a delay on these attacks. It is really getting to me on those attacks, at least. There's a couple other ones that I do better with. We will see if we can't have a knight take that middle spot here. Knight versus, I believe it was a goblin. And I lost still? I thought that this was supposed to be a little bit more on my side. And if I lose this, I'm done. Wizard. I have not fought with the wizard before. How does the wizard attack? Alright. Wow. And I got the floor wiped with me, and I think that means I lose. Yep, the game is ended. Dark side wins. Wow, that did not work out well for me at all. We'll go again and see if I can't do a little bit better. But that is not good. Okay. We'll start by moving you here. Try to stay on the light side, but it doesn't matter if I can't win a single fight that I get into. And we'll have you go there. And then you move there. Okay, they took a control point, but that's okay. I might be able to take that one back. Yeah, the ranged ones are the hardest for me right now. Try to take that middle spot again. All right, so the Phoenix, I believe, is the one that I'm not a huge fan of. Yeah, that's the attack. All right, we got you. I let you get a hit in because there was a delay on my attack, but it still worked out okay. Ish. All right, imprison. Who are you imprisoning? My genie. It is done. Archer, go there. We'll try to take some of the control points, try to get an early victory, I guess. Right, Archer versus Goblin. I should win this, but watch me fail. Yeah, he's so strong! He's so strong! Two hits, and that would have taken me, I think, four of the range. I'm just not good at the range. Can't get the range to work for me. All right, Valkyrie there. All right, we got another range attack. I need to learn how to use the range better. But the way that it controls, right, you hit the direction first and then you hit the button. I can't... You can already see my health bar not doing well, too. Come on. No! I tried! I really did try! Just didn't work out well for me. Alright, Genie, that is imprisoned, so I can't do anything there. We'll just move you here, I guess. So I don't see much of them on. Oh, this is not going to work out well. Alright, we got the same attack here. I keep on expecting him to come my way, but the computer is very good at this game. And then, yeah, I got delayed on my attack. Like, they're able to attack faster than I am, because I have to be still for a little bit. Oh, sorry about that. I have to be still for a little bit. Mashing the computer did not work out for me there. I have to be still for a while before I can attack, and they do not. You can, like, you might be able to hear me, like, hitting the button a ton, trying to get this to work. Come on. Ow! I was trying so hard to attack there. See, this is me hitting the button as often as I can. And it's just not work, like, that's as often as I can attack. Now, supposedly, the game's supposed to adapt to my skill level. Supposedly. I somehow won that. I will take it. I will take it. All right, I'm going to have you heal. Revive, summon elemental, exchange, shift time, heal. I'll heal you. power points are proof against magic. Spell is canceled. Choose another. I thought I was able to heal somebody there, but I guess not. Summon elemental. Send it to the target. Gonna take you on. Because you're on a light tile. Alright, this one functions like a gold. Jeez, right off the bat! No, what is going on here? My keyboard is not agreeing with me. Wow. Alright. The computer's just gonna be better at the range than I can be. And they get to summon an elemental up against my genie, which is very similar controls, so watch me lose this. I tried so hard. Wow. The game's controls just aren't where I personally need them to be. All right, we'll move you there. Those are getting darker, aren't they? All right, the Phoenix again. I really wanted that heal. I got a little bit of an attack in. But, like, we need to be so close, and they can be so far. That freaking dragon's gonna get me. Okay, so gonna need to send you out to get you. Watch me lose this, even though it's a basic goblin. Nope. They can dodge so well. And I cannot. Alright, I got one hit in. Got it. Alright. That shouldn't have been that close. Alright, your turn. We will try it. Like it's supposed to be on my side here. Nope. Yeah. I got one. I just need one more. No! I went for the attack. I can't move and attack as quickly as they can. And that's the problem here. Alright, spell. Teleport. What are you teleporting? Oh, this is not going to work out well for me. I never moved that unicorn. Alright, unicorn, use your laser horn. I got a hit in. Oh my god! The controls... I keep on hitting the Windows button is what the problem is. Which, of course, is not something I should ever be doing. Knight, try to take that, I guess. Nope. 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 Nope! I don't think it even attacked. I think it just ran into me, and that's what killed me. Manticores are poison, after all. All right, you're up. Like at some point, I do have to take on the sorceress if I'm ever going to win, but I don't think that's going to happen. I'm going to move the golem there. Actually, if I remember right, I like using the golem. But that doesn't mean anything for me. If I can't actually win a fight... All right, we'll go straight. Yep, yeah. I tried so... Oh my god, I'm hit... You can hear me hitting the button. Jeez. Like, I'm hitting the button so much and it just won't attack. All right, use the golem again up against... I don't remember. Wow, right off. Like, I can't move fast enough as the golem. It's too slow. Okay, well, take this PowerPoint. Why not? Come on. Nope. Like, every time that I'm doing that stutter step, it's me trying to attack. And it's not going. Like, it's not attacking. This will be the last one. I'm clearly going to lose this. It's just a matter of time, but... I'm going to have to blame it on the controls. They're just not working the way that they should. Come on. I got a hit in, but it doesn't matter. That one's got range. The computer knows how to use that. All right, they're going to take this PowerPoint as well, because this one's also got range, and I don't, and it only took one hit. Did you see how much health that thing had? I think I technically got a hit in, and it just didn't care. Okay, we'll move you there. I think I can stretch that there. I'm going to go for it. No. Let's try to take that spot. Come on. I mean, they're playing this right. Yeah, one hit's all it takes. On those kind of tiles, like, they're so strong. How much can... We'll take you. We'll do this. All right, the golem's going to move slowly, but... Oh my god, you... Like, I had that attack. I cannot attack. Jeez. Yeah. All right, we're clearly going to lose this. I'm running out of pieces to even win. But, like, this pains me. All right, you can move 4. We'll try to take that spot again. The manticore cannot live forever. Use your unicorn horn. Use the lasers. I got it. At the end of the day, I got it. That's what's important. I guess. Why? Okay. Just gonna take this out, huh? One hit? This was so light, though. The color was so light. That thing is so strong. Oh, this is... like I said, I'm running out of pieces. I literally cannot win at this point. There is nothing I can do to win because I have 4 pieces. You know what? I could technically, but I don't know what to do. I need to revive something. That's the only way I can do it. And the dragon's just going around just wrecking house. The knight versus the dragon. You would think the knight would be a little stronger, especially on something this light, but oh, come on. It was so close. No! I almost had it. All right, so technically I can't win. What I was thinking before was that I could revive and bring something back. I wouldn't even know what I would want to bring back. I guess the genie. We'll put him there. Can I not put him there? Put him there. Oh, and you're gonna heal the dragon. The dragon that just absolutely wrecks me every time. All right, you can go here. And then they're gonna send the dragon after me because the dragon just absolutely destroys me. Yep, 2 hits. 2 hits! And I think I only get 1 revive per match. If you guys could just kind of go for the victory here, that would probably help me out. They're just sending the dragon, just dragon attack after dragon attack. Come on. Nope, 1 hit. Dragon's too strong. Oh, it's my turn again? We'll take you on. Why not? I forgot what you are. Wow. I clearly don't have a good strategy for this, but the computer is too strong. Yeah, I'm probably going to lose this. It's my strongest character against its strongest character on a tile that should favor me, but I will clearly lose. Oh, I still win. The wizard holds his own. I don't know. All right. What? Cease conjuring, imprison, exchange. That one. And that one. Right. Of course. I cannot choose that. Cease conjuring, imprison, shift time. Shift time, what does that do? The flow of time is reversed. Oh, that'll change the color on the tiles. All right, well, so much for that. She just reversed it right back. All right, let's move here. Revive, and here comes the dragon. They're very positive on that dragon. Okay, we'll do what I can. Wow. Yeah. All right, so I'm out of pieces. Do I officially lose now? I kind of sacrificed the wizard at the end. All right, so I think I did worse this time than I did the first time. I'm going to blame the controls on that one because it just was not shooting when I wanted it to shoot. But that is the game now played, and with the game played, let's talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, it is fun at first, I would say. As time went on, I got more and more frustrated with how the controls went. I think it is much better as a two-player game than it is a one-person game because the computer is too good. The computer is very good at controlling the pieces in those fights, and it's difficult for you as a player to be able to match what the computer can do. So as I was trying to do things faster and faster, the controls worked worse and worse for me. I started making more and more mistakes, and it just progressively got worse as we went on. But overall, I would say that the game can be fun, given the right circumstances. That is kind of where my mind goes when I think of, is the game fun? It can be, depending, but it would be much better as a two-player game than a one-person game for me. In terms of the graphics, I think the graphics are actually pretty good. The things look relatively like they're supposed to look. It is a very complicated chessboard. There's a lot going on with that chessboard, so the graphics aren't necessarily going to be as good on each piece as I would like because there's so much going on the screen. There was a bit of screen flickering, especially when it came to those points of power on kind of the five parts of the board. Those were just kind of constantly flickering. The gameplay, I think the concept is great. I think there is a lot that can be done to improve the controls to make things a little bit easier for the player and a little bit less frustrating to do what you want to do in the game. The sound, I think, was actually pretty good. I think that the opening theme was something that was a little unexpected and something that I particularly did enjoy. That opening thing, especially the fact that it was definitely trying to be a Star Wars theme while not being Star Wars. I think they got away with it. I hope that I will also get away with it when I upload it to YouTube, and we'll see if YouTube flags it, but that's a whole different thing. The game itself, I think, is good. In terms of replayability, I think it's only replayable if you can play it with other people. And once you start bringing other people into the equation, it's not necessarily the game that is replayable. It is the fun times with the other person. But I wouldn't necessarily say it's replayable when it's you versus the computer until you can get the hang of the controls, which is something that I definitely could not get. So would I recommend this game? Ultimately, I would say no, unless you can get somebody else to play with you. Then it can be fun between the two of you trying to get the game to be on more of an even playing ground between you and your opponent. But I know that there are better versions of this kind of game that come later. This kind of battle chess style game. So I would possibly skip this one and play one of the later ones that maybe control a little bit better for you. And that's my modern take on the game. When Archon was released, it was critically successful. The critics were fans of the game. The critics loved the game's originality, the strategy, and the gameplay. The game would also be popular among the customers. It was seen as the most popular Atari game of 1983. As time has gone on, views on the game have remained positive. Archon frequently makes lists of the greatest video games of all time. Archon would see a sequel and a remake. We will keep an eye on these as we continue. As for Electronic Arts, Archon would be the first of many successful games the company would make. We, of course, will keep an eye on Electronic Arts as we continue. As for Free Fall Associates, although they would continue to create video games and we will hear from them again, it will be only briefly. That will do it for the story of Archon for now. My name is ballerscuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we take things back underground.